In this lab, we're going to create a notification template such that when you base other, when you create new elements based on the element template that is associated with that notification template, you'll automatically create new notifications. Now we're going to start on in this environment by going to the Pi System Explorer. If you haven't seen this before, it's under the Start menu, All Programs, Pi System. And it's called the Pi System Explorer. This is where we have access to AF and also notifications. Now the database we're going to use is this one called solution_notifications_learning_lab_database. Now I'm going to start by choosing the elements. And we're going to create an element template for this element here called device status. It's pretty simple. All you do is do a right click and choose, this is going to be convert to template. And we can't really see what's happened, but this has created a brand new element template. I'll go ahead and check this in. The next step is to start creating new elements and then assign them to that particular template. I'll go ahead and choose within elements, choose a right click and choose new. New element, you can also choose file for that. So for the reference type, we're just going to let the default stay, which is parent-child. And for the element template, we'll use that one that we just created, this device status template. I'll do that, and then I'll do that two more times. As you can see, I'm just letting the defaults stay here. So we're just going to, as we create these, we're just going to increment the name. So we'll leave this with the device status template. It's going to be based on that same template. Here's device status 1, device status 2. And finally, one last one, number 3, and we'll go ahead and check in these changes. So all 3 of these are now built off of that template called device status. What's next is to go into the notification section, take a look at an existing notification that actually makes use as its trigger that device status. So I'll go into notifications. It's called status notification. Go back to the overview here. And we're going to do something very similar. Here, we'll just do a right click. We're going to convert this to a notification template. So here's my notification template. It's called status notification space template. Same name as the originator. The originator was called status notification. And I'll go ahead and check this in. Now you notice these templates, they do show up where the other templates will show up, which is in the library. So element templates, such as this, notification templates, they're all part of the library. Now, next up is to go back to that notification right here. And because there is now a template based on this notification, we have an option here called /new notification from template. We can build a brand new notification from the template that we created from this notification. Now when I click on this, it's going to give me a choice of which template to use. In this case, I do want the one that is that we just created, this status notification template. And now I get the opportunity to demonstrate the first thing about these notification templates. Look how easy it is to extend the notification that already exists for this first one. As you can see, it has an existing notification. To extend that to the other 3. So these are the ones that are, well, we can see where they are in this path here. We'll go ahead and extend that notification using this template to these others that are based on the same element template that this device status is based on. So that creates 3 brand new notifications. I'll go ahead and check those in. And we can see now under notifications, we have brand new notifications with their own triggers, contents, subscribers, history, etc. All based off of that template. Well, that demonstrates one of the real nice fundamental new features of notification templates. You can extend notifications to other things based on these notification templates. Now let's look at one more interesting feature. What I can do is I can change the options here so that or such that every time a new notification or an element is built off of a specific element template, then we will automatically generate a notification. And that's done very simply. I go into that notification template and I choose this option right here under Creation and Startup Options. Actually, we're not going to be quite that aggressive. We'll just create the notification. We're not going to start it. So what types of elements are we going to be targeting here, or which ones are actually going to get the new notification? Well, if you take a look at the definition of this notification template, we see right there the target is that device status template. And that's because of the way we created this. If you recall, let me go ahead and check this in. If you recall, we started out with this element template called device status template. And that is the target. Any element based on that element template is the target for new notifications, automated notifications based on this notification template. So notifications are always tied to specific elements, and that's how we tie the notification template to a specific element template. Now, the grand finale to this would be to create a brand new element and see if, in fact, it's doing what we think it should be doing. Let's kind of look at before and after here. If we look at notifications, currently we've got these four notifications, the original plus these three. I'm going to go ahead and create a brand new element. So I'll go into Elements, New Element. Again, we'll base this on device status template. That's the key there. If this is just a regular element not associated with this, then that will not generate a notification. But because this element template is the target for that notification template, this should have the effect we want. I'll go ahead and check this in. As you can see, just through the check-in, you can see that indeed, if you go into notifications, there is another notification that's been created. So here's that new notification. We take a look at its target. It's that device status 4, the one that we just created. That was the element that we just created. Now, any element that we create that makes use of that device status template is going to get that notification.